What is up, New Beginnings Church? Happy Monday morning to you. Welcome to our devotional series. So great to hang out with you this morning, but also have sad news too. This is the end of the red letter words. This is our last week because we're in Matthew chapter 28. So we started this journey saying, hey, we're just going to walk through the book of Matthew. And every time there's some red letter words that jump out, we're going to land on those, really start with the red letter words, and then maybe circle out and find out what the context is. And so for me, super refreshing just to walk through the book of Matthew again. It's been a while since I just walked through it. Just one chapter, the next like this, but it's been fun. I hope you've enjoyed it too. And so next week, we'll do something a little bit different, maybe take a couple weeks and just kind of keep it just really encouraging words from Scripture. And then I think I have a new series that I'll kick off at some point once I'm ready. And so I'll tell you more about that in the future. But today, here we go. These are red letter words from Matthew chapter 28. And we're going to spend the whole week on this one big thing called the Great Commission. And it's got all kinds of different thoughts and ideas and components to it. This is what Jesus said. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Oh, so we call it the Great Commission. This is almost like what we just believe was a very clear and concise statement on what Jesus wanted the disciples to do in light of his absence and the sending of the Holy Spirit. And so almost just start with this one big word, go. Everybody say go, type it in, whatever, shout it from the rooftop, go. When it says go, it says make disciples of all nations, baptize them. We'll cover all the other stuff, but let's just start with go. As a matter of fact, in the Greek language, it has this kind of present progressive tense to it. Almost this idea of it's not like, hey, go one time, or hey, go to one place. It's more along the lines of in your going, I mean, as you go through life. And so one of the big questions that we want to ask ourselves is this: okay, God, what do you want to do with my life? What's your purpose for my life? And really, it does have to do with being a light to the world and salt to the earth. And so as a matter of fact, let's read those words. Jesus said, Matthew 5, you are the light of the world. He goes, a town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand. They give light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. So, you know, I want to combine these two ideas of like God wants you to go. And in your going, I want you just to go and do good deeds. I want you to go and be the light of the world. I want you to go share the love of Jesus. I want you to go and build the kingdom wherever you go. I want you to go and share the good news wherever you go. And so the big question I want you to wrestle with is this. As I go, well, where do I go? Well, sometimes you just go to the mall. Sometimes you go to Trader Joe's or Safeway. You know, sometimes you go down the street to your neighbor's house. Sometimes you go to church. Sometimes you go to school. Sometimes you go to work. Actually, most of us probably go to work a lot. And so the big question I want you to ask yourself is where am I going in terms of what are the realms of influence that God has given me? Because I don't think God's saying, hey, you need to go to China and you need to go to Africa and you need to go to Argentina. No, most of us aren't doing that. We're in our going. And so every day you wake up and you usually go somewhere. And so I just want you to consider that every place that you go is an opportunity to be light and salt and love and blessing, to be a kingdom builder and a good news bringer. And so I want you to be on the lookout when you go to the grocery store. Maybe you bump into somebody that you haven't seen in a while. Maybe you bump into a random stranger and you just feel compelled, hey, how can I maybe be a blessing to them and serve them today? As you go to school, I want you to think about this. You are surrounded by people sometimes at school that you get to influence, love, be kind to, help, invite to church. For most of us adults, work is that big time environment. And again, I know a lot of times over the past year, we think, man, my going has changed. Well, here's the deal. You're still going somewhere and doing something. And so as you go, that's the big word. What are the realms of influence that God has given me? What are the places that I go to? What are the spheres of influence? Because when God says, go change the world, I think what God's really saying is go change your world. Whatever it is that God's given you, think, how can I go into that environment and be light and love and light and blessing to all those around me? And so let's let that be our prayer today, that as we think about this Great Commission, we start with the idea of like, no, in my goings, as I go, Where am I going? What are my realms of influence? And so let me pray for you today. Heavenly Father, let us to consider that every place that our foot goes, God, is an opportunity to be light, life, and love. God, help us to step into those environments. And as we go, no matter where it is that we go, let us be gospel bringers and kingdom builders, Lord. Help us, we pray in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody say amen. Church, I love you. God bless you. I will see you tomorrow.